Here, g of f of 1 equals negative 2, and g of f of x equals 3x squared minus 6x plus 1. Great solving if you got these two right. For this first problem, we'll start by finding the f of 1. We need to find the output when the input for f is 1. So letting x equal 1 here and here, we'll have a new expression. 1 squared equals 1, negative 2 times 1 is negative 2, and then we'll have positive 2 on the end. Summing these together, we get a final output of positive 1. So we know the output is 1 when x equals 1 for f. So we can replace f of 1 with its value, 1. Now we just need to find the g of 1. Plugging in 1 in for x here, we'll get 3 times 1 minus 5. So that equals negative 2. This is how we find g of f of 1. Now, to find g of f of x, we're going to take f of x, this entire function, and we're going to plug it in for this x here. Remember, f of x is going to be the input for g. So wherever we see x for g, we replace that with x squared minus 2x plus 2. We distribute the positive 3 to get 3x squared minus 6x plus 6. Then we just combine the like terms on the end to get 3x squared minus 6x plus 1, g of f of x.